It is North Augusta, and we are just about there. How are you today?
Good, how are you?
Not too bad.
Spending the weekend here, or just for the day?
Just the night. Likewise, have a good day. Decide easy, but they do a good thorough job making sure that people don't leave intoxicated, which hats off to the OPP. Here we go. Welcome to Augusta Motorsports Park. Kick her up a notch. We're about to get down and dirty.
You are now watching ehTV.
It's all right. It's the way it goes. Could have been me.
Hey, racing.
Right on. Let's get a couple of shots of that. How's the young lad doing? We got Patty up front. As I figured. Patty lapped
them? No, Lenny and the other guy.
Lenny and Patty lapped the others?
Yeah.
Give her, Patty. Hit her, bud. Nice. Nice job. Patty's got a lot of racing experience. He's in limp mode, guaranteed. Yeah, limp mode. Yeah, she's overheating.
looks like something spraying out the top back there.
Lenny was in second.
We got time to go to the mud pits. Good job, Patty. Good job, buddy. She's limping, eh?
You're doing good, too.
Well, still good fun, isn't it? Next time, man. Next time.
What's up, buddy?
Well, you know, just in front of your up the asphalt.
You look some pissed off on running that paver there on Friday.
Well, I just my focus, buddy.
Poker base, eh?
A little bit, too.
I saw this sitting there in front of your place, and I thought...
Picked her up Sunday.
Did you?
Yeah. I kind of wish that I had to take the front diff out of my other one and put it in this one.
Yeah?
And I kind of wish that I had left the front diff in the other one with the snorkel on it. Because there's some good deep holes here this year.
Oh man, you know what the best part about it is? It's got the kick plate, but I left it at home because I didn't really steal it.
Roger! Love it! Side though on the outside of it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Generally, it'll fill up from all the shit that you're hammering down. Oh! No! No! Me! Got her! You got her! Is right.
It's 300 kilometers.
10 oil changes will get her back. You gotta be careful in here, man. Just let it down. Don't try to walk out of it side to side like that. This place is bad banks, right?
Yeah.
You just got right on the side of one. You're gonna get your toes fucked up and out now.
I won't save.
It's a beautiful bike, but
like titanium.
I've had it for 2 weeks.
Shit happens. Shit happens.
I'm gonna run. Fuck, I don't even know what to do.
Don't start it. Take it back to where you're at. Pull the air filter out. Tip the fucker up. Then pop both spark plugs. Crank it over until they come out dry.
Thanks.
Check your oil after that as well. If you find she's mixed, don't run it at all.
You don't fucking say.
Well, I guess we got one swamp.
I think it's leaking through that.
The gasket, right? The air filter?
Yeah.
Probably took a little bit, but at least it's on the outside.
But it's not nothing happening to the micro, I didn't hear.
Nah, because the filter will absorb whatever the needle bit, but the rest will just go down. The air box is really nicely designed.
It's all dry in there. It's all dry in there.
Yeah, because it's running right down the channel like it's supposed to.
Yeah.
They designed the box so anything gets in there, it's going to run down there first. It has to fill all the way up to the filter before the bike can start taking it in.
Oh, really?
Otherwise, the filter will absorb whatever.
I've been letting out every day coming around through the water. Yeah. It's only like, you know, you can build that little cap.
Take it off, put a layer of dielect grease all the way around that cap.
Yeah, I'm going to put it back on.
Well, I don't blame you.
It's all fucking running,
man. And it's so sandy. I like, honestly, this shit's hell on bearings and bushes.
That's what I said. It's pretty fucking deep there.
Really sorry to see that lad swamp a brand new XMR. That sucks. Pits are pretty damn deep. Dad's having fun. That's right. Girlfriend wants to go for a ride, see what the back 40's like. We'll take care of it. I'm kind of curious to see just how bad it is, and I'm expecting it's going to be bad. With all the rain we've had, it's pretty moist here. This is one of the wettest of gusts I've seen. Even the roads are all mired, screwed, soft. Girl. Alaska, that way, that way. Yeah, hold on. Nope. You actually want to yank into the hole. You want to go this way and a little burst of throttle.
Okay, you jump on here.
Oh, it's okay.
You jump on here.
What you got to do is you take your body weight and you yank it to this side. And when you get the full yank, you give it a little pop, a little pop, a little pop.
You do it.
You'll get it.
No, no.
Try it first. Come on now, don't be a poor sport.
I'm really fucking funny.
Don't lift off of it. You want touchdown on this side.
I'm touchdown.
With the tires though. Which means you want to yank your body this way on the bike like you're going to tip it over, but you're not going to. Yep.
It just went worse.
Gonna be tough for sure.
They're all just loving you.
Okay, so I'll lift up on the ass of the bike. What you want to do is barely roll the tires to keep them moving, okay?
Slowly?
Yep.
On it?
Yep. No, never on it. First thing you do when you get stuck or you're having issues is get your weight off the bike.
Oh.
So you stand beside it. So you'll just stand there and
slowly
roll it out. Okay, one, two. Keep them moving, keep them moving. Too late, ready? One, two, go. Keep them moving. Yeah, but this time you have to give a little more gas. One, two, go. Not quite. Okay.
Okay, what am I doing?
It's all right.
Sorry.
It's all open. It's not going to be easy. It's not going to be easy in here. Never is.
Thank you.
got this. Nice and easy, nice and easy. Yep. Hey, girl. It's all right, hold on. Back up about 3 feet.
Yep.
And then give it full throttle and low. You're just going to rip right through it. Yep, yep. It's gone. Good, good. Put it in low. Hold that until it comes out.
Really?
Yeah, it ain't gonna flip up or none of that shit. You're good. You got her. Now, nice and easy. Well,
I'm stuck on something.
Well, you don't want to go into that. Fuck, Lee, because you're gonna have to go right back into it. But you pulled out of it. Yeah. Unfortunately, I think we got to back
you. Something again. See, this is not fun for you.
Oh, that's all right. Let's see. Let me see. Winch you out, and then we're gonna have to go around shit and get you out of here. Hey, yeah, yeah. That's how it goes. Yeah, I see that. I think we got this axle broken too. You got low battery voltage, so you got no winch. This is what 4x4 and is. Problem is, we got a broken axle over there too. I think maybe both on this side are broken. Although that one's not turning either, which makes me think it's...
That's what I was saying, this one's not turning, it just keeps...
Well, it might be the front diff. Can't pull you backwards into that though. And we got the front end up, so you want to work with that because this is worse. Get you out of here either with all these broken axles. This isn't even the worst of it.
Do you have your phone on you?
Yeah. Bike and just a little bit of gas, get that that tire is the only one working right now.
So just slowly?
Very slowly, but just make sure it's rolling and I'll try to pull you up and out. We'll see. It's probably just gonna pull me in. Second one from the start. Yep. Whoa. drive. I'm gonna try to position myself and then pull you out here.
I'll avoid this one.
Yeah. Get you spun around. Try to back it up.
Try to back it up?
Yeah.
How far?
Enough that we can get you cut in there. Go ahead. Whoa. Okay, hold on. What I'll do is I get in front of you, I'm gonna tow you.
Can you take me on that?
You want to go on the back of this?
Yeah.
You're fucking insane.
What?